Hi everybody, it's me. We are going to do a little coloring today, and you'll have to excuse me when I get the camera set up. I'm using my iPhone, but we're going to be coloring this beautiful H, which is going to be available in Colors of Hope that is coming from Revell in March on the 7th, to be precise. So let's get started. The first thing I do, and I will talk as I turn this. Let's see. Oh, there it is. Sometimes you like some of your drawings better than others. And this is one of my personal favorites. There it is. All right. The first thing I like to do is do a color palette to pick that out at the beginning. Although I do not, I don't have to stay with it. I will definitely go off base camp a little bit. And that is fine with me.
I do not.
Oh, I just, well, here we go.
I don't have to stay with it.
I was hoping.
I would definitely go off base.
I was hoping I could look at it on my page and then see what was going on in the comments. But, oh, I guess I can just turn off the volume.
I was hoping.
There we go. All right. My volume is off. All right, folks. All right, now, what I like to do is pick a palette. I just have right here, I have a bunch of Sharpies. I just got them on sale. And I like Sharpies because they're inexpensive, especially if you get them on sale. So, I'm going to go with, I think, a cool background contrasted with warm, the warm H. So let's start with some little background. And around the edge, I think I'm going to do a rainbow pattern. I love rainbows. So I'm going to arrange my supplies in a sort of, oh, that's more blue, prism fashion here. Keeps it easy to do. So you can see how I'm doing this. That is coming up sideways on the thing. I'm sorry about that, but I think you can see what we're doing. The purples, pinks. There we go, and we did a nice green right in there. All right, I'd love to know what you're doing. Oh, yay! I see Wyatt and Rhonda are here through Wyatt's page, and Jared, who is my son of the heart, he's here too. And I love it. He loves my hair. Thank you. I'm a little bit unsure about the length, but that's okay. That's okay. So let's start with the prism around the outside. And to keep just a little bit of continuity, I'm going to do all pink on the corners, because that is awesome. You don't have to have a big plan. I like to kind of figure out things maybe one step ahead of time, but not too much, because I don't like to limit myself like that. I am not a person that wants to be limited too much. Oh, Jean Wynn. Oh, man, I love you. I love all of y'all. This is awesome. Oh, you know what? Latanya. I don't know how to pronounce your name. I've only seen it, and I love you, too. This is so fun, y'all. I'm going down. It's so neat to have these friends online. People that do not understand the connection that you can feel to people. Because words are words, right? They don't have to be spoken. They can be written. And written words should be a little bit more thoughtfully said. That makes a difference too, doesn't it? Oh, yes, Jean, I use Sharpies because I'm cheap. You know what? This is a pastime right here. This is something that if people have the means and want to spend a lot of money on their supplies, have at it. But you don't have to. You can get a box of Crayolas, if for that matter. Let's see. I'm going to refresh my page because something has happened to the video. There we go. Awesome. If you are working on something, post a picture in the comments. That would be so much fun to see. And then everybody else that's following gets to see it too. There's something about rainbows, y'all. They are one of my favorite things ever. Rainbows are real signs for me too. Like, there have been times in my life where I just wasn't sure if I was on the right track, what I was doing, and you know, God sends rainbows to me. Sometimes even double rainbows. Do you remember that funny video about the guy with the double rainbow? I've seen triple rainbows too. Oh, could you please give me a phonetic thing of your voice, of your name, Latanya or Latane, whatever it is. It's beautiful and it looks beautiful. That would be a really pretty lettering project. Latane. Oh, yay. Okay, good. I had a very difficult maiden name. And so I really appreciate people trying to, you know, get it right. Yeah, I like Sharpies, Jean. They do just the trick that I'm looking for when I'm coloring. I know there are people that like the Prismacolors. My daughter, she does illustration work, and she likes Prismacolors, and they do have such beautiful, beautiful different colors to choose from. So you are limited by the Sharpies, of course, but that doesn't matter. Sometimes you find your greatest creativity within limitation. Oh, thanks for the share, Jean. That's awesome. Oh, thanks, Karen. I try to be inspiring. It's hard sometimes. Let's see. I'm still. There we go. Back up. All right. It's kind of nice that Facebook has this because I'm a little bit technologically challenged. Ooh, that's a pretty color. I didn't even realize what that was going to look like. I like being surprised. Sometimes, though, it's a little too surprising. The cap looks completely different from what comes out of the pen. Like, the Prismacolor orange is pretty dark. But I'm just sticking with the Prismacolors today. And then the red-orange is pretty dark, too. But that's okay. It doesn't have to be a complete gradient scale going on here. Well, yesterday, it had done this like little snowy kind of very light precipitation, but it stayed because it was so cold. And it was this total winter wonderland here. I mean, it was amazing. I've never seen, even like from the bottom, the trees were. I can't remember if this is the color I use. I know this one isn't. Even from the bottom, the pine needles and everything, it was just absolutely beautiful. It was so beautiful. I can't even. And it stayed. So Jean Wynn, I know you lived here, so you have seen that. I've never seen anything quite like it. Everything was absolutely sugar-coated, frosted. It was so beautiful. I was so happy to be alive yesterday. Thanks, Sarah. Kelly and I used to be in a, we started as a Bible study group, but we never got to the Bible study. So we ended up calling it a, what did we call it? The Beth Moore Rejects. But we were there to pray with one another. That's, you know what, we let the group be what it was. And we didn't feel guilty. We just did it. We drank our coffee and we cried and prayed. And that was a very, very special time in my life. Oh, Sam says hi. Hi, Sam. Yeah, it's a beautiful place, Jean. I'm so happy to be living here. Kentucky's beautiful, the bluegrass state. It really is. I love it. The scenery there, the horses, you know. I mean, you can't... There's not too much beautiful as far as the animal kingdom than a horse. But there are such beautiful... The mountains here, I can't... I just can't believe it. I step out my door to take the dog to do his business in the morning and there's Pike's Peak. I mean, really. That's like the most awesome thing. You're coming this summer, Jean? Oh my gosh, yes. That's really exciting. Yeah, that was great, wasn't it, Kelly? I'm so glad we met then. Kelly and I both ended up moving away. That was during Maryland time. So the weather has turned, though. It's in the 50s and very, very, very breezy today. So it feels more like March. It's sunny. All the winter sugar snow has gone. You couldn't see the mountains yesterday. Everything, the atmosphere was so close. Let's see what else is going on up here. Yeah, I love technology in the sense that it makes it easier and easier for people like me to do something like this. Can you imagine how hard this would have been a few years ago? There's no way. There's just no way I would have even done it. Amy Connell, hi, sweetie pie. Let's see. There are a lot of beautiful coloring choices out there today. The world is full of people willing to draw beautiful pictures so that others can color them. I think that's a wonderful thing. Coming around the border here with this orange. My daughter told me to make sure that my hands didn't have anything objectionable on them, and I think that was very good advice. Oh, here it comes. Look at, now is this, hi, Michelle. Where's McLeod today? McLeod is still asleep. Saturday is her sleeping in day. This is so fun, y'all. Man, I'm having such a nice time. All right, let's see. Now we're going to start on the background because I like to do that first and have everything like pop out. So you can see we have all these stripes. I'm really not sure. I might just leave these white because that negative space is really important. I think when I'm coloring, I don't need to color in every little thing because then you've got the contrast of the white in with everything else. So... let's start with this lighter blue. You should color, Jean. This is a community time. I'd love it if people got out there coloring and just did this along with me. Otherwise, honestly, this would be kind of boring, wouldn't it? Just for me to sit here talking while you all listen. I am under no delusion that I'm that interesting. My hair is curled, though, so, you know. I did go a little out here for, even though you can't see it. I don't know, the older I get, the harder it is to go the extra mile with stuff like curling irons. Hi, Michelle, yay! Aw, smiley face and a heart. I can always use a smiley face and a heart. I love emojis, I think they're... I guess emojis is wrong, isn't it? It's like saying deers. Coloring is one of those things that it really does help if you deal with any kind of mental challenges in the sense of depression, anxiety, that kind of thing. Oh, what kind of paper? I am using, I don't know. I just printed this out. The kind of paper that's going to be, it's going to be a thicker paper in the book. It is, thank you for saying it's like Bob Ross. I love Bob Ross. That is like the biggest compliment you could give me, Gene. He was the coolest person. Like, I think if you can find a nicer person on that ever lived, I would be shocked. I would be shocked. Oh, you're totally coloring, Rhonda. Yay! I love it. I have been to Adams Mountain Cafe, Jean. That is my go-to place. McLeod and I love it there because there's a lot of vegetarian options. And the food is, you know, not filled with chemicals and that sort of thing. And it's reasonably priced. So we go there. That's our go-to place when we want a sit-down meal. Happening on my all right. It says my storage option is almost full, and I was under the impression that this was not storing to my phone. So if it is, and this cuts off, I will delete stuff and I will be back. What I love about coloring is it's no pressure. Do whatever you want. I think that's why it's so soothing. You don't have to make this about the finished product. You can make it about the journey and just doing it. It's kind of wonderful that way. I have found this to be very helpful in my, search for good mental health. I've come a long way. I'm just going to use a little pipsqueak. Here we go. We're even going a little bit down the path here. This is just the little Crayola washable markers called pipsqueaks. You can see they're a little more rugged in their coverage. But I don't mind that. Just adds a little bit of different texture to the piece. You know, if you don't have a whole lot of expectation going in, you can just enjoy the process. And a lot of times you may pick a color or do something you think, oh gosh, why did I do that? But then it ends up looking fine. So you can't even judge what you're doing too much, you know, while you're doing it. Just wait till the end product to make up your mind whether you like it or not. And if you don't, who cares? It's a piece of paper. That's all. For some reason, artwork holds a lot of mystique for people, and I've never understood that. And I guess it's just because I grew up, my father, he was an eye doctor, and so he would come home from work at night when I was young, and he would set up his easel, or well, it was always set up in our family room, and he would paint. So I grew up with artwork just being one of those things, you know, it's like you eat supper and then you go down and you paint. And it never held that sort of mystique to it. It is special because you're creating beauty, and I think anything that creates beauty is special. But that doesn't mean there's a mystery surrounding it, or some people deserve to do it and others don't. Oh, hi, Sean. Just checking out the comments. Let's see. Nope, no. Does McLeod color? You know what? Not too often. Every so often she does, and she really does a good job. She has a good eye for color. I am just going into these pipsqueaks and picking out all the different colors. Also, you'll have to forgive me, too. I do not have very good eyesight, believe it or not. So I will leave little spots of white poking through when I'm, you know, coloring. I've got cataracts. I always, whenever I need an excuse for something, I always say my cataracts were acting up. Oh, this is a beautiful color. I love this. If you asked me what my favorite color was, I couldn't tell you. I mean, I guess I could make something up on the fly if, like, I absolutely had to, but then why would I? But I love various color combinations. That's so much fun. This book is going to be beautiful, y'all. Ravel did such a good job. And they're really nice people to work with. See what this is. Oh, even darker blue. One of my favorite combinations is a really dark cobalt kind of blue. So a blue with a lot of red in it and gold. Oh, I think that's so pretty. A lot of Mexican tile has those colors in that, and I think that's gorgeous. Oh, I just saw some spots I missed. That'll happen. What's it like in your neck of the woods, y'all? You dealing with cold today, or are you getting some break in the temps? Oh, I love it, Jean. I know. Judging by my wardrobe, my favorite color is black. Which is so not. I mean, I use black to outline and to, make other colors pop. But I don't have the fashion sense I used to. The book is out on, I have a hard time thinking and chewing gum at the same time. March 7th it comes out, and I'm going to be doing some giveaways, and for people that, come on the page that day, and that's going to be fun. Let's see. Still got some more options here. Oh, yeah. Now, let's see. I'm not sure what color this even was up here, but it'll be close enough. So So a lot of people do find relief from their symptoms, you know, somewhat from their symptoms of depression by doing small motor skill projects. I've tried a lot of different ones, and I did coloring while I was in massage therapy school, and that was very helpful. I put color and then put on a television show and follow it while I was coloring. Do marathons when studying was getting to be a little bit too much and I needed a break. But I've done other things in my life as well. You know, needlework is another one that I've done. Ooh, I'd love to be on your podcast, Jean. That'd be awesome. Low 50s and sunny here in Mississippi. You have the same weather we do. Isn't that great? It's crazy. Two very different parts of the country experiencing the same. Now, do you have the wind that we've got here, Rhonda? Because it is just blowing like crazy out there. So now that I'm kind of in the middle, what I'm going to do is go back. Oh, I miss things all the time. It doesn't matter that I drew it, I still miss it. But that's okay. Back to this pretty cobalt. Super windy in Kansas today, too. Man, I, drove across Kansas for the first time last year, Michelle. And, the western part of the state is flat, but boy, it is not a, I just always pictured it as, you know, completely flat, and it is just not. All those rolling hills towards the east, it's beautiful. I even like the flat. There's something about being in the middle of the dome of the sky, and flat land makes you feel that way. You can just turn around and you're just, it's like the world revolves around you. So you might as well enjoy it, because Kansas might be the only place or any other flat place where the world does actually feel like it revolves around you. Well, maybe it feels like it a lot of the times. I don't even know what this color is. Well, let's see. Doing a lot of darks here. That's all right. And I'll do a lot of contrastings. And the sun sets in Kansas. Oh my goodness. I've never seen colors like that in my entire life. I mean, purples. Oh, good, Kelly. Enjoy your coffee outside anyway, even though it's chilly and dreary. That's the way to do it. Here we go, a little lighter color. So now we're going up the scale, back towards the bottom. If you don't know color theory, get a color wheel if you want to make your colors pop a little bit. It's really worth it. They're cheap, and you know, you just go opposite. So if you want, you color in a purple area, then go across the wheel, and you can go straight across, or you can go, you know, somewhat close to across. But gold is going to be a good contrast. Green is going to be a good contrast. And that will make your colors pop out. And you can also think of warm and cool. So if you feel like your works are looking a little muddy, think about how you're using contrast in your colors, and that will make all the difference in the world. And sometimes you don't want it. Sometimes you want a completely warm feeling, and that's cool, too. That's cool, too. Crack myself up. It is healing, Michelle. The open sky in Kansas is extremely healing. We found that sort of landscape, it's like the energy of life doesn't get all balled up. So I have a story about Kansas. We were in our RV at this time, and we were taking it to its final resting place with my friend Kirsten Jackson in Okmulgee, and she wanted a guest cabin, and so she was putting out good thoughts for a guest cabin, and I needed a place to land that RV, and she took it, and it became her guest house. But we were on our way there. I had just bought our little car for us to use out here in Colorado, and got it pretty cheap, little Honda CRV, and it was, I mean, we only had it 2 days, and my daughter, McLeod, was following, and she pulled off on the side of the road. It just didn't matter how much she pressed down on the accelerator. Well, the timing chain broke, and we had to have a complete valve job done, which cost about as much as the car had cost. But we're out in the middle of nowhere because she hadn't driven for a while, so she wanted to stay on the back roads. And thankfully, there was enough signal, and I could call AAA. But I'm going to tell you, you know, we just had bad luck with cars for the past year. And I threw a hissy fit inside the RV. It was just a full-out hissy fit. And we ended up, the man who came and rescued us had an RV hookup. And he was the nicest man ever, a widower, and it was a small garage, and the valve job took almost 2 weeks, and he let us stay there the entire time. I've never seen such hospitality, just such hospitality. And so I threw this hissy fit, and help was already on the way. Like, God had already gotten our needs were met, and there you have it. So that happens to me a lot. So I'm learning finally not to have the hissy fit and to just know that things are taken care of, and that has made my quality of life a lot better. All right, so we have the background. I like the way this is looking. Blue and orange is Rhonda's favorite color combo. I love blue and orange. Yeah. It's beautiful. It's like that one step over from purple and gold, isn't it? Yeah, it's wonderful. And Jean had to go, but that's okay. I'm so glad she was here. All right, so now we are on the main portion here of the H. And I guess this is upside down to you all, so I'm going to just color it upside down so you don't have to see it upside down. I got this little flower from an Art Deco tile motif, and so I used that. Isn't that pretty? So I can't claim absolute credit for that, but I will claim the brilliance to actually use that. There's nothing new under the sun. And once I realized that, my life as an artist, as a writer, as a creative person got a whole lot easier, because I wasn't always thinking I was the most creative person in the world, and everything I did had the touch of the complete unique upon it. Oh, look, the thing I have underneath there is coming through. I have a piece of cardstock underneath here to keep this from bleeding through on the table. I'd still like to see what y'all are coloring, if you're coloring out there, Rhonda. You're supposed to pick. So what I'm going to do here is I'm going to just layer the color a little bit. Now the orange in the pipsqueaks is a little bit lighter. So just because something is in a block does not mean you have to just do one color. And I know some of you know this, but we have people that are just starting artistic pursuits with this sort of thing with coloring. So I feel like any piece of help I can offer is not too mundane or too basic. Because I know when I'm starting out with something, I appreciate that kind of helpfulness. Start orange in here. Oh, good, you posted on your wall. Oh, Sherry. Hi, Sherry in Texas. Making biscuits. Oh, my gosh. You post the most amazing food. Oh, man. I wish I could eat one of those biscuits right now. I love homemade biscuits. They're the best thing. We're all being creative here. Okay, so now I've got this orange, and I know it looks like it's going to blend with that, but it's not. That's not what we're going for. So now I'm going to get the Sharpie orange, which is a little darker. I'm going to do that final little outline around here to give it some depth. So if you do deal with mental health issues, it's nothing to be ashamed about, first of all. There are a lot of us out here. And there are some of us that, we reach out to others. But there is always a sense that we're suffering alone. Even though sometimes we suffer alone together, if that makes sense. If you've dealt with this, then you know exactly what I mean. But you don't have to. You can come and color with me. It is a very hard place to be because you do feel very alone. I'm doing very well now in my battle against my own mental illness. And I will tell you, one of the things that has remarkably changed my ability to function in this world is that I have radically changed my diet. I know that's probably not what anybody wants to hear, but I have. I really have. I have given up a lot of dietary things, and I don't drink alcohol anymore. I don't have anything morally against alcohol. I guess that's okay. I don't have anything morally against alcohol. I mean, Jesus turned the water into wine, so I don't want you to hear that I'm making any kind of statement like that, because I'm not. But I am, I find that I am a much happier, whole, healthy, better person when I do not engage in drinking of any kind. It's the next day. The next day, I'm just absolutely, I forget what a beautiful life I live and the gift of life that I have been given by God. It's easy to forget about that when you're suffering with these mentally debilitating thoughts. So I don't eat sugar anymore, and I don't drink alcohol anymore, and I don't eat sugar very often. Every once in a while, you know what? I'm going to have a piece of birthday cake or a birthday pie. McLeod just turned 20. She's out of the realm of the... Oh, I just found a little bit of a darker yellow to do a little segue here. But McLeod just turned 21, or 20, and we had pecan pie, which, oh, you know what? I could eat a whole pecan pie. I could. I could eat an entire pecan pie, and I would have no problems. So I stopped eating sugar, too. And that has made a... That's probably been the most single dietary change I made recently. Within the last 6 months, I made that shift, and that's been huge. About 6 or 7 years ago, I stopped using drinking diet soda, using sweeteners, that sort of thing, and that was extremely helpful. That stuff is just plain old bad for you. And it doesn't keep the weight off. Your body, you know, your brain goes, oh, sweet, let's start storing some fat. So it's not helping you any. It's just poisoning your system, and nobody needs that, least of all you. You're too good. You have too many people that love you and need you, and you can treat yourself better than to pump yourself full of that stuff. I know there are people that are going to be like, but I love my Diet Coke. No condemnation. I just want the best for everybody. Oh, Don Pape gave me a heart. I love you, Don. You're a good man. Don and I have known each other a long time in the publishing realm. And he has supported my work and my writing, and I'm very grateful for him. Ooh, I really like this kind of light green craziness. This is nice because it's warm. So it's going with my warm theme. Got some more leaves over here. It says my storage is almost full, but I don't know if it's just telling me that or it's because this is recording. If this is recording, my phone would have been full a long time ago. Yes, Susan, my dear friend who I love with all my heart, it is me right this second. Good job on your stats test, by the way. Way to go. I wouldn't even, I wouldn't have a prayer with a stats test. Like, I don't even know. Oh, I know. Isn't this a great color? Sugar is the devil. It is the devil, Sherry. Yeah, it's really, and this, you can see, I'm not doing anything that requires an intense amount of manual dexterity at all. If you can just color along a line, you've got it. You've got it. And like I said, you can't do wrong here. You just can't. This is your work. You get to do, this is, it looks like this is going to be a pretty color. You get to do whatever you want. And you know what? Love it. Love what you do. I used to apologize. Basically, it was like, sorry for breathing, you know? And then I was like, what am I doing? And I just started to love what I do. You know what? Maybe this isn't Rembrandt, but he's dead and I'm not. And I'm enjoying myself, and that's what really matters right now. You know what I mean? I love you, Susan. I wish you were here. I wish y'all were here, and we'd have just some coloring time. Even not coloring, just sitting around drinking coffee and chatting. Oh, thanks, Rhonda. Yeah, isn't that easy to do? That's just so easy to do. You really can just outline the little different sections that you're coloring, and you will be able to, you know, create a lot of depth, and it just doesn't take a whole lot of, you don't have to be scared to do it, is what I'm saying. You really don't. Well, this little pipsqueak marker is on its last legs. Oh, that's all right. It has that mottled natural look. Oh, Susan, I'm just using Sharpies. Just simple Sharpies. And then this is just an old box of these little pipsqueaks for kids, washable markers. I don't really, I was saying there are people that, you know, invest in the Copic markers and, you know, the more expensive ones. And I say good for them. I do not. My daughter does illustration work, and she, my older daughter, and she uses Prismacolors in her work. She uses all sorts of real gentle, beautiful colors. And I'm kind of like a bull in a china shop when it comes to color. I don't know. I just love all the colors. I love all the colors. All right, so this is my coffee, and I have not given up caffeine. That's going a little too far, folks. And I'm going to do the same with this here. Just outline around the leaf a little bit. See how easy that is? It is like Skyping with my hands. I love you big too, Rhonda. Have a wonderful, wonderful Saturday with your beautiful brood on the lake. I love you so much. Rhonda is one of the funniest people I know. When I go down and visit her, I just get ready to have a sore stomach afterwards. It's like, because that's what's going to happen. That is what is going to happen. All right. So I'm going to go ahead and do this outline here. Oh, this right here. This is one of my most favorite colors in the world. I do love all the colors, and I cannot pick a favorite. But, oh, just a beautiful warm gold. Isn't that wonderful? Now, in Colors of Hope, you know, there's all the letters for hope are done like this, and I'm hoping that people will want to color them and then, you know, get square frames, and you'd have a really nice wall arrangement with the word hope. I have tried, and you know, I've read all sorts of spiritual literature. I think all truth is God's truth. And so, you know, I've read all sorts of things, and I did read one time where it was just like saying, remove all hope, because if you, you know, that is placing some kind of expectation, and you can only be disappointed if you have any kind of expectation. And well, yeah, I mean, if you want to take that to its really far conclusion, I think there's a middle ground there. But I tried it. I tried living without hope for about 2 weeks, and it was horrible. I was like, no, this clearly is not for me. Now, living without expectation, that is, and that's human expectation, right? Like, I don't try not to expect anything out of anybody anymore, because that's not fair. You know, most of the times we expect things out of people, things that they never agreed to. Why should they meet our expectations if they never even agreed to that? You know, but we're like, oh, it just made me so mad that she did that. Well, did she ever tell you she was not going to act like that? Probably not. So the expectation is one thing that, to me, is that's a misplaced hope in human beings. But hope is knowing that God is there with me 24/7, all the time, and that He is with me for my good. And once I really started to hope in the goodness of God, then that was a huge step in the healing of my mental illnesses too, was that I really did believe it, and I just said, I'm going to do this. I'm going to believe God, and I'm going to believe he's good. I was taught that God is just, you know, kind of just there for some people and not others. And if he can be there for some people and not others, you know, then I could be one of those others. So once I totally got on board with God's goodness and love, then it was amazing how much different my life began to play out for me. So hope is real. It's a good thing. Just place it in the right place and the right, I'm going to say the right person, but you know, I mean, we tend to anthropomorphize God anyway. Oh, Susan went to put her dinner in the crock pot. Oh, that sounds nice. And I will post a final picture of this. Absolutely. That would be wonderful. I do like the way this is coming out, y'all. So you can see I'm setting myself up to make things. I'm going to go with the lighter yellow, but I'm going to fade it in a little bit here. You can do no wrong. I had a martial art instructor that told me that many times. It gave me a lot of confidence in my art as well. So, this little color, let's see what this is. Ooh, that's a nice little lemony yellow. This is nice because I feel like I'm not alone here, and I'm not. I love Pinterest. I go on there a lot to get inspiration. And it's a friendly place. It's been a little hard on Facebook, right? But that's okay, you know. If you can just look beyond people's words to, they're probably pretty scared. And there's where you can have a little compassion. This is an opportunity for compassion. Not judgment. Oh, Michelle, I love the stuff you do, and I love your drawings that you do. Oh my gosh. I'm always on your Instagram page. I have a template and a light board. That's how I do my mandalas, so that I know I've got the right proportions for what I want to do. I know a mandala is actually a, we've come to use that as a generic term when it's a Buddhist art form, you know, that I don't even know. I couldn't even tell you what what the different things mean, but it doesn't matter anymore. It's been taken to mean a beautiful, round, symmetrical drawing, and I'm okay with that, and any true Buddhist would be as well, wouldn't they? Right. Oh, y'all, we're coming down the home stretch. Ooh, I forgot about this. Yeah, no, it's true, Michelle. You do beautiful artwork. Instagram, there's another friendly place. If you're looking for a little respite from the opinionated world of Facebook, let's just put it that way. And everybody's entitled to theirs, right? Then try Instagram. It's a lovely place. I love it. People are friendly and, you know, it's a good thing. I don't know what I want to do here. I guess I'm going to go with the lighter orange. All right, now I'm going to get into this background here. Oh, hi, Angie. How are you? Angie is a lovely, lovely woman that I have met online. I just love all the online friends that I have made. I'm so grateful. And Angie always has a positive attitude with whatever life throws at her. And I think she is a real example of a strong woman. A lot of strong women in my life. And I'm very, very grateful for that. What I am most delighted about on my page and in my life is that I have friends that have many, many different beliefs. And I still love them all. Because I don't love people based on that. I love people based on my own capacity to love, not upon what they believe or even their capacity to love. Although most of the people I love have a great capacity to love. Not that I can't be a stinker, because I can be a stinker. I'm not too kind, Angie. It's the truth. I think it's fun to see all the different things people do with their lives on Facebook and social media. Things people are excited about and put their time and energy into. Sometimes with coloring, you have to stop and kind of see what's really going on. Like I have these spots to fill and then these outlines of other things, but you could easily get a little bit confused as to what should be orange to make it all cohesive. So sometimes it really is good in with certain things like this to see what's going on before you start coloring. If you go out of the lines, you know what? The world is just not going to end. It is not going to end, folks. I will tell you that. Let's get these little guys. Ooh, I've got this little flower that echoes that over here I'm going to have to do. What a chore. I'm going to have to do that. It's funny how you get onto another step and you find all the little ones you missed. I guess I need to look a little further here. Here we go. All right. So do y'all have any good plans for the weekend? I'm going to be doing a lot of writing. I'm going to let you in on a secret. I have been writing since 1992. So 25 years, and I have just gotten to the point where I actually enjoy it. Isn't that terrible? Oh my goodness. If Flannery O'Connor said I write because I can, well, that was me, but I didn't do it. That wasn't necessarily a good way to be. All right, folks, we're going for the pink. I really want to try hiking here. I have not really ever done much of that, and it seems silly to be living by the Rocky Mountains and not do some hiking. So, and I really need to get myself back into some kind of, you know, more physical activity. I am not a gym person. I am not, you know, I just don't like to exercise. But I like to learn how to do things, so. I started ballroom dancing, but I was one of the taller ones, so I had to do the man's part, and I didn't want to learn that. I didn't want to learn that and then have to unlearn it. So, there went that, but I've got the pretty shoes now. But I really would love to learn how to do that. I love pink and green together. I don't wear it because I'm not that flamboyant a gal. But it's so pretty. It's almost Valentine's Day, y'all, for all you people with significant others. That's fun. I love the sound of the wind. It's really blowing out there. You know, this is a good time too for you to, if you're a person of prayer, to pray for other people. And those in your life that you know could use a little love and care from you, sending them good thoughts. That's a nice thing. All right, boy, I am not even remotely sure what to do with this outline. I think it needs to be dark so that everything else can just pop out really nicely. So I think I'm going to take, this is very dark plum, because that's coming. It's nice. It's a nice warm purple. Now I'm taking off my glasses here, folks, and getting serious. Oh, now that I'm looking up close, boy, could this use a little help, but that's all right. It's my cataracts acting up. Oh, yeah. Oh, I like this. Yeah, so don't just think about what colors match. Think about how they contrast, and you're going to get a really much more vibrant looking finished product. seeing if there's any more comments. Oh, I really like that. Ooh, yay. Wonder how Sherry's biscuits are coming. I love home cooking. Oh my goodness. I don't eat a lot of meat anymore at all. I call myself a love-atarian because if I'm my own choice, I just eat fish. I don't eat animals. But if I was going over to somebody's house and they served roast beef, I would eat it because I choose love over everything else. And I would never want to put a person in that kind of position where they feel like they did something that wasn't good when they were being loving and giving. So that's what I am. I'm just grateful, you know. I'm grateful when I go over people's houses and they spent time preparing food and making a home for me, a temporary home in their home. It's one of the most beautiful things about being a human. It's practicing hospitality. We were given a lot of good hospitality on the road. Oh, y'all. I really like the way this is looking. Oh, thanks. Thank you. This tattoo McLeod and I got to commemorate our travels together. And so there we go. It's a compass rose to do that for all of our times. We're coming down the home stretch here, y'all. Now here's this thing here, like, I totally need a line there. I like to listen to music while I color, and I don't want to put music on now because I know you might want to listen to your music, and then you'd be forced to listen to my music, and I do not want to do that to anybody. Oop. A little spot of pink I missed. I love purple. Purple's a great color. Y'all, we're almost done. Those of you that are still with me, thank you. I appreciate it. It's nice to, I feel like I'm just having a little time with friends. Boy, that's nice. You know, if you've always felt like you've wanted to do art but can't, maybe coloring would be a great way to get yourself to introduce yourself to it. There's no pressure. Shoot, you don't have to show anybody if you don't want to. But if you like what you did, you should show it off. And it's so important to like what we do and to like our lives, because then we tell by liking and loving what's around us. You know, we give God permission to give us more of the same. But if we are always in a state of grievance, then there's not too much to work with there. Because it's sort of like, well, I don't think anything I can do will make this one happy. I don't know if God feels that way or not. I'm glad I'm not God, because I probably would. Let's just go ahead and do this here. There we go. All right. And I think I'm going to leave these white and these little stripes here white. That is the H, y'all. We have done the H. Oh, Mark. Mark. Mark, quotation mark. Cloud, how are you doing? Christine, hi. Oh, thank you. Good. Fine tip markers are great too for the tiny spaces. I love it. I love it so much. Yes, so this is it. This is the finished product. Is this little H right here. Let's see. I'll turn it this way. That looks good. Oh my goodness, y'all. This was really fun. I'm going to scare you and put myself here. Oop, wrong way. Let me flip there. All right. Thank you so much for joining me with this coloring. That was a lot of fun. It was so nice to interact with all of you. And I hope you have a wonderful weekend. And I have a little message for you. What kind of life will you create? It is up to you. So have a wonderful, creative, beautiful, awesome weekend. I love you. Lots of love, lots of joy. Bye-bye.